Hello, my name is Debbie Kelly. I'm a field specialist in horticulture with University of Missouri Extension. Last time I was with you, we were talking about direct marketing, specifically at a farmer's market. Today, I'm going to talk to you about community-supported agriculture. So community-supported agriculture is a subscription opportunity for you as a marketing option. Essentially, you have shares of the products that you have that you're growing on the farm each individual week, and a share can be dependent upon the size of a family. Your customers then purchase a share, and that share can be, for example, I was a member, I had four people in my family, and I paid for a four-person share, and I paid for 32 weeks of the year for the growing season. I received whatever product was available at that particular moment in time that my family could eat for a week. So that's community-supported agriculture. So let's look at some advantages and disadvantages. Some advantages are is that you as a producer get to have interaction with those customers, with those that are purchasing your farm products, and you get to know what they like, what they don't like, and you can start catering your products that you're growing to the customers that are purchasing your food. It's also an opportunity for you to do a lot of education. When you do community-supported agriculture, you have lots of different types of vegetables that your customers may not be familiar with, such as kohlrabi. My mom wasn't familiar with that product at all, and so I had some. I brought some to her, and I showed her what it was. I explained what it was, and then we ate it, and she simply loved it. She's upset she can't find it at the grocery store, but she can get it at some of the different farmers markets and through the CSA. You also have an opportunity to get your upfront money. In other words, with a subscription, just like a magazine, you pay for the magazine, and then for a year, each month or each week, whatever it is, you get your magazine. And that's the same with the subscription for community-supported agriculture. Customers will pay upfront. You've got that money upfront, and you're able to actually subscribe and provide the product for the folks. You're also guaranteed that cash flow. You get it up front. You know how much money you have, so you'll know how to be able to spend that money. So what are some of the disadvantages? Disadvantages are that you have to be great at cash management. In other words, you're going to get your money up front, but you still have expenses throughout the growing year. So you have to know how to handle those funds. Great communication skills. So as a subscription, you are actually going to have drought, flooding, hailstorms, insects, diseases that affect the quantity and the quality of the product that you're growing on the farm. So your CSA customer has to also be aware that they may not get as much of your vegetables and fruits each week as what they might be accustomed to or what they think they might. So they're actually taking a risk as well as you in the growing season. Know your limits of how much to grow. Sometimes farmers are going to grow way too much, or they may not grow enough to be able to supply what the needs are each week for your customers. Location is also important, rural versus urban. Chances are if you're on the peri-urban or urban fringe, that's going to be okay. You're going to have lots of customers that would be interested in your community-supported agriculture. If you're in a rural area, you may not have as many customers. So you might have to do a lot more marketing to try to get as many customers as you might like, as many shares as what you would like to sell. Folks that are very interested in local foods are very interested in having a subscription with a CSA. If folks in your area are not interested that much in local foods, they may not be interested in a membership as a CSA. You also have to know your customers. What is it that they like? When I was a CSA member, my family loved fresh spinach, and my farmer had a hard time with growing spinach for some reason. So what she did is she planted extra rows, knowing that she wanted to keep me happy. So that also was good for her and good for me. Also, you have to know and keep your customers happy. It's easier to retain your customers than it is to go out to find new customers for your CSA. Next time, I'm going to talk to you about selling to restaurants.